Good morning, students. In this lecture series of transportation engineering, in last lecture we studied about one of the important highway material, that is soil and aggregate. In this lecture we are going to discuss about the third and most important binder material, that is bitumen. Also tar and asphalt is there, which is also known as binder material. In this lecture we are going to discuss about bituminous and the different tests which are carried out on the bituminous. So let's start with the binders. The materials which is used in road construction for binding together the road aggregates and providing a smooth and impermeable surface for movement of vehicular traffic is called as binders. The common binders are used in road constructions are cement, bitumen and tar. The cement mortar or cement slurry is used as a binder in cement bound macadam roads. However, cement is used as a main ingredient in construction of cement concrete roads. Bitumen and tar are the most commonly used bituminous binders in road pavement construction. Such roads are also termed as blacktop roads or bituminous roads. In road engineering, the term binder significantly refers to bituminous materials only. What are the functions of binders? The various objectives achieved by binders in the road construction are, first, it acts as a cushion for the road surface and absorbs the kneading and abrasive action of wheel roads. Second, it makes the road surface impermeable, that is, it seals the surface against ingress of water. Third, it acts as a binding agent, that is, it binds the surface particles together, thus checking any loss of particles from the surface by suction under the action of moving loads. Four, it makes the road pavement durable, that is, it resists the action of weathering agencies like wind and sun. In short, it ensures long life for the road pavements. Then bitumen, a non-crystalline hydrocarbon compound in a solid or viscous state having adhesive properties and derived from crude petroleum either by natural or artificial distillation is termed as bitumen. It is completely soluble in carbon disulfide, that is CS2. The properties of bitumen depend upon its source and the method of preparation. Important properties of bitumen following are some of the most important properties of bitumen. First, it is a mixture of hydrocarbons and is black or brown in color. Then second property is, it is an important byproduct of fractional distillation of cube petroleum. Then third, it is a viscous fluid or semi-solid and melts when heated. Then four, it is an important binder used for binding road aggregates due to its adhesive nature and waterproofing properties. Fifth, it can be produced in a variety of grades with varying softness and volatility to suit particular requirement of various types of roads. Then the sixth property is, it is completely soluble in carbon disulfide and carbon tetrachloride. Okay, you can see the chart showing fractional distillation in manufacturing bitumen or asphalt, that is crude oil, and the temperature has been shown, distillation cases has been shown, that is fuel oil, lubricants, cylindrical oils, kerosene, petrol, bitumen or asphalt has been shown, approximate distillation temperature has been shown. Okay, then what are the grades of bitumen? There are generally two grades of bitumen, paving grades and industrial grades. Paving grades are used for road construction work and industrial grades which are used for waterproofing works. Okay. The paving grades available in India for highway construction are two types, A type and S type. Okay. You can see the image cross section of petroleum deposits showing oil tapping. Bitumen is obtained from this crude petroleum. Folded rock strata ground level has been shown. The impervious stratum, gas, porous, impervious stratum, salt water, etc. has been shown in the cross section. Okay. A type denotes paving bitumen obtained from Assam Petroleum. These grades of bitumen are generally designated as A35, A65, A90, A200, etc. And S-type denotes paving bitumen obtained from other sources. These grades of bitumen are designated as S35, S65, S90, S200, etc. Then desirable properties of bitumen for road construction. What are the desirable properties are bitumen are required for the road construction we are going to discuss about. In that, first, adequate viscosity and fluidity for easy and efficient spraying. Second, unsuspectable to temperature variations. Third, durability. Fourth, adequate affinity and adhesion with road aggregates. Okay. Then second, tar. After bituminous, one of the binding, most important binding material, tar. Tar is a viscous liquid, jet black in color, obtained as a residual product after destructive distillation of coal or wood in the absence of air. Based on the natural organic matter from which tar is obtained as a byproduct, it is referred to as wood tar or coal tar accordingly. Coal tar is more popular and widely used for making roads and is also referred as road tar. The other important type of tar are wood tar, peat tar, bone tar and water gas tar. Except water gas tar, other types are not considered suitable for road paving. That is, peat tar, bone tar, wood tar are used for the road construction or road paving. Okay. Then what are the properties of road tar? Following are the properties of road tar. First, tar is a temperature susceptible product, resulting in great variation in viscosity with change in temperature. Second, it is not soluble in carbon disulfide and carbon tetrachloride, but is it soluble only in toluene. Third, it has a great content of free carbon and is readily distinguished by its typical odor, that is smell. Then fourth, it is more resistant to disintegrating action of water, so it is more suitable to be used below ground level as a waterproofing material. Then fifth, its weather resistance ability is inferior. Sixth, it is more volatile and hardens rapidly when exposed to air. Then comparison between bitumen and tar. These are the two major binder materials which are used for the construction of roads. So let's compare with the bitumen with tar. In first, bitumen, it is a black or brown in color, obtained by distillation of cube petroleum, while in tar, it is also black or brown in color, but produced by destructive distillation of coal or wood. In bitumen, second, it is soluble in carbon disulfide and in carbon tetrachloride. And in tar, it is soluble only in toluene. Okay. Then third, in bitumen, it has good weather resisting property, and in tar, its weather resisting ability is inferior to bitumen. Then four, difference or comparison between bitumen and tar. It is less temperature susceptible. And in tar, it is more temperature susceptible, resulting in great variation in viscosity of product with temperature. In bitumen, the free carbon content is less as compared to tar. And in tar, the free carbon content is more and is detected by solubility test. In bitumen, sixth, due to high viscosity, it cannot be tested as orifice viscometer. And in tar, tars and cutbacks are generally tested in orifice viscometers for viscosity tests. Then third binding material is asphalt. The term bitumen and asphalt are often confused. They actually refer to the same material. The word bitumen covers both tar and asphalt, but conventionally, bitumen stands for asphalt. Asphalt is more used in road construction than the tar. Definition: bitumen containing some inert material or mineral substances is referred to as asphalt. It is of two types: rock asphalt and natural or lake asphalt. Okay, so let's start with the rock asphalt. Rock asphalt is a bituminous limestone used for road pavements. It contains 70 to 90% of limestone and 10 to 20% of bitumen. The natural asphalt found in lakes and containing 40 to 70% of bitumen and 30% of water, lime, clay and sand is termed as lake asphalt. Refined lake asphalt separated by application of heat is the best material used for road markings or road makings. Then cutback and emulsion. Cutbacks, the solution of bitumen or asphalt in a volatile solvent like kerosene, spirit, creosote, etc. to reduce the consistency is termed as cutback. It contains 80% bitumen and 20% solvent or dilutant. A cut actually refers to a volatile liquid which is distilled off in an oil refinery. To prepare a cutback, the distilled cut is put back into its residue, and hence the name cutback is used. What are the functions of cutback? A cutback has following functions. First, to soften the heavy or solid bituminous material and convert it into a liquid form. Second, to apply it easily over road aggregates without heating or using minimum heating. Third, it can be used for all types of bituminous roads. Fourth, it modifies and improves the properties of residual product in refineries which has otherwise little commercial value. Then what do you know about emulsion? A liquid material in which a substantial amount of bitumen or tar or asphalt is suspended in a finely divided state in an aqueous medium and stabilized by means of suitable emulsifier or stabilizer is termed as bitumen emulsion or road emulsion. It may also be defined as a two-phase system or a mixture consisting of two emulsible liquids. The one dispersed in the other in the form of fine globules or droplets. Okay. Initially, bitumen or asphalt is broken up into fine globules of size about 3 microns, that is .003 mm, and dispersed in water. A small amount of emulsifier or emulsifying agent is added, nearly 1%, to facilitate the formation of a stable emulsion and to keep the globules of dispersed bitumen in suspension. The common emulsifiers used are soaps, resinous substances, colloidal powders, etc. Emulsion contains 50 to 60% of bitumen by weight and the remaining portion is water. When emulsion is applied on the road, it breaks down the binder globules, start binding the road aggregates, but full binding powder develops only after evaporation of water. Then what are the functions of emulsion? Following are the most important functions which an emulsion performs. First, it can be applied easily at normal temperature without heating. Second, it is very suitable for coating over damp surfaces or in wet weather conditions. Third, it is ideally used for maintenance and patch repair work of bituminous roads. It can also be used for stabilization of soils. Okay, so in this lecture we discussed about the third binding material, that is bituminous, tar and asphalt, which are most important highway materials. Okay, thank you very much.